Welcome, rugby fans, to Rugby 411. I am your host, as always. My name is Joshua Shibata, and hopefully this will be a fun little video. I ended up having a bit of time on my hand, which I don't have very often. Still a little bit behind in watching rugby. I mean, now is a great time to be a rugby fan. You have the Six Nations competition going on in Europe, which I just finished the first round of action. I got to catch up with round two. There is a Super Rugby Pacific, which is going to be starting in the Southern Hemisphere, which is focusing on Australia, New Zealand, and the newer teams of Pacific Moana and Fiji and Drua. Obviously, we have Major League Rugby going on. And then, of course, you have the European competitions, with Premiership, United Rugby Championship, Top League 14 in France, Japan's Rugby League, Japan League 1 is going on. And yeah, I am kind of watching a little bit of everything. So it's a great time to be a rugby fan. But another really interesting aspect of rugby, and it's something that, I've been a sports fan all my life. Mostly football and baseball, and hockey. Kind of fell out of love with baseball and hockey a little bit, but I've never been a huge jersey fan, as in the kits, or we call them kits in the rugby world, and in soccer it's also referred to as that, but jerseys that the players wear, especially American jerseys, I feel kind of are not exactly super exciting. They're kind of plain, and I think that's just the American mentality. But once I became a rugby fan, especially with international jerseys, you start to see a whole slew of just really creative and sometimes not so creative jerseys in the world of rugby, and I've become a huge rugby jersey collector, and I do want to give a shout out to my loving girlfriend Leva Bates for kind of helping me get onto that. She bought me one of my first jerseys, a Team Japan jersey, and so I've grown my jersey collection. It's not a huge collection, it's only about 10 jerseys, but considering I just started picking up jerseys maybe a couple years ago, you know, it's not too bad. It is kind of focused on certain teams, you know, obviously Giltinis. With Major League Rugby, I have a few jerseys of the Brave Blossoms, which is the Japan national rugby team, both the 15s and the 7s. I have my favorite Japanese team, the Suntory Sunglasses jersey. Obviously, I have Team USA's latest jersey, which I'm wearing right now, which I do love this design. I think it's really, really cool. Though I know they're going to have a new one coming out later this year. And I have another really wonderful gift from my girlfriend, Leva, an old school Japanese jersey celebrating one of the first Japanese player to ever go into the Rugby World Hall of Fame, Dai. It's a great jersey, a throwback to one of their original designs. So again, just started collecting my jersey. And what leading to this video, which we'll eventually get to, is now how I've become just fascinated with the jerseys that rugby players wear. And Major League Rugby has done a habit of releasing every year new kits for most of their teams. And it's kind of become, you know, a topic of fashion. So what I wanted to do with this video is to review, kind of put on our fashionistas cap on, or jersey on, and kind of go over and review all the jerseys of all 13 Major League Rugby teams. And also I wanted to compare it to them to last year's jerseys and kits. And maybe we could play around with this. We can kind of vote, have you guys, the fans, vote on your favorites, and maybe do a little bit of a tournament competition to see which jersey is the best in Major League Rugby for this year and this season. So again, fun little topic of conversation, and let's get to it. We're going to start with the Western Conference, and we're going to start with the Austin Gill Gromies. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you their jerseys for this year, And then we're going to compare this year's jersey also to last year's, just for like a little reference point. I'm kind of debating what we're going to do with the competition. I think what I want to do is, because every team has an away and a home kit, some teams like Rugby New York, and I think the New England Free Jacks have a special fan supporter jersey, which I think is really cool. They have a third jersey, which only the fans can kind of buy. And then, obviously, throughout the season, like, what Major League Rugby also does, which is really cool, they'll have limited edition jerseys, like a veterans jersey celebrating Veterans Day, a pink jersey celebrating Breast Cancer Month. So they'll release little jerseys here and there. But what we're going to be basing it on is their predominant home and away jerseys. I'm going to show you right now Austin Gilgroni's jerseys, and then we'll compare it to last year's jerseys. So the Austin Gilgroni's jersey, I kind of like it much better than last year's, and we're going to show it. But this year, they are doing a nice little number with the burnt orange and black. The home and the away is really just a simple flip of the color schemes. But I like it. Now what we'll do is we'll kind of look at last year's jersey comparison. We're going to start with the home version. I believe this is the home version. Yeah, home version. So as you see, the 2022 version has the orange and the black on top. The 2021 version, kind of simple, kind of plain. Not a huge fan of it. Obviously, also the changes. The 2022 version has one of their sponsors, Ascension Seton, which I'm going to start saying about, and this might be also kind of a newer concept to American fans, because obviously with most of your NFL, your Major League Baseball, hockey, not a lot of sponsorships are allowed on the jerseys. With rugby and, or mostly international sports, with rugby and football or soccer, they're usually studded with sponsorships. And really, to me, I don't mind it. Some people do kind of take objection to it. I don't mind it, but some sponsors have much better looking logos that look better on a jersey than others, and it kind of makes or breaks sometimes a kit. And you know, the Ascension Set one isn't too bad, but we'll see some other ones where I kind of feel, you know, it kind of brings down the quality of the jersey. But that's Austin. And then the reversal, which the away kit with the reversal black and orange, you know, I kind of like the black on top of orange a little bit better. Their 2021 one, which is basically just a white color compared to the orange. I'm a fan of whites, but I'm not a fan of this. I don't like this one. I think it's just too plain, too simple. I really feel Austin improved quite a bit on their 2022 jersey, and I feel it's one of the better kits for 2022. Moving on, the next one is the new kids on the block, the Dallas Jackals. Again, if you didn't know, they were originally going to start last year in 2021. Of course, we were still going through the pandemic, so literally at the last second, they kind of backed out, and now are starting quite impressively, in my opinion, in the 2022 campaign. But they already released this jersey number for 2021, and obviously it's 2022 as well. So we don't have anything to compare it to, but we'll at least look at this one. And you know what? When I first saw this, really, really liked it. Now that I've seen it on the players, on the pitch, I still love it. It's a great color, the teal green. I can go either way, to be honest. If we do a voting between the home and away versions, this one's going to be a tough one. I like both. I'm more obviously more partial to black than white, but I think the teal green works with both of them. And but I kind of will pick the black one a little bit more, but I love it. I think, honestly, it's one of the best jerseys was going to be of 2021, now 2022. So well done with the Dallas Jackals to start off with having such a cool-looking jersey. Moving on, we have the Houston Sabercats. Now, this is their 2022 kits. You know what? When I bring up the 2021 ones, I'm going to say kind of disappointed in this jersey. I feel the 2021 kits were really, really good. And I'm bringing up now the home kits for Sabercats, 2022 on the left, 2021 on the right. As you see, especially this black one for the home was just really, really cool. You know, Aviva Stadium is where they play. Aviva is a sponsor for them. Again, the logo for Aviva, very simple, but it works. It works a lot. Obviously, they took it off for the 2022, kind of replaced it with the little lines. I'm not liking it. I'm really not. I felt the 2021 one was so much better, and it just seems kind of lazy to me, this 2022 version, where it's just lines. And then they do similar trick when I flip it over to the away, like what Austin did, is they just flip the color scheme from yellow and black to now black on top and yellow on the bottom. But as you see also too, the away version of their kit from 2021, the neon yellow, again, just, it was a really cool kit. Again, one of my favorite ones from last season. Now it really has been downgraded. I'm not a big fan of this 2022 Sabercat kit. Not a fan. Moving on. This is the 2022 kit of the reigning and defending MLR champions, the LA Guillotinis. I didn't have a picture to show you of the 2021 kits, but I did something better. Like I said, I'm a kit collector myself, and I have, and you've seen this, I have both the home and the away kits for your LA Guillotinis. Now, the honestly, I think these, for a first-year franchise, were something really special. Like, just the black and pink, I come from a pro wrestling background as well. I'm a huge fan of pro wrestling. Nobody's worn black and pink better than the Hart Foundation and Bret the Hitman Hart, but the Guillotinis came damn close. I mean, it's really a beautiful number, this black and pink. The Guillotini logo is a smart G with the Guillotini, the martini cup, the Guillotini cup. So real simple, real sweet. The white home version, they honestly flip and flop between saying which one is home and which one's away. They really wear whatever doesn't clash with the opposite team. But most of the time the black one is usually their home, but they usually label the white as their home. But the white version, more with just the simple Guillotinis logo, in letter form with the little Guillotinis cup in the corner. But again, I feel even this one, you know, real simple, but it works. White with the kind of the hyper neon blue and the pink lettering. Now, we'll pull up the 2022 version again. You'll see it's pretty much the same kit, just slightly different. If you look closely, and I'm going to circle it, all it is that you have these now, the little stripes on the collar and on the cuffs. You know, I'm not surprised. Again, they just started as a franchise. It's kind of surprising that they would make any big changes in year number two for their kit, because why would they need to? Also, I haven't seen the Guillotinis wear this 2022 version, so I don't know what they're going to do with that. Maybe they'll wait until it actually goes on sale and it's available to them as well. But to be honest, really no need for a change. I think they just changed for the change's sake to show the difference between 2021 and 2022. With that being said, I still love the design. I still think it's one of the best looking kits, and I'm not being super biased about this. I really do like the look. It looks real sleek, very classy, kind of, you know, very Hollywood and LA-ish. So I love it. I love the LA Guillotinis kit, which is why I'm also kind of proud to buy and wear it. Moving on, we have San Diego Legion. This is their 2022 version. Now, again, talking about logos, I feel they have one of the best sponsored logos, Bolas Point, a brewing company located in San Diego. Just the logo is really cool. I'm not 100% sure what it's supposed to be, but it kind of looks like a cool mask. But it fits. It really fits as a logo to put onto a kit. So I think it adds to the kit and to the look. We're going to pull up the comparisons. This is the home versions of the kits from 2022-2021. Honestly, 2021 is almost just as good. I don't know if you can see with this picture, but if you look at a really high definition picture of the 2021 kit, they have a little background imagery of a Spartan helmet, you know, because they're the Legion. So really cool design. The black works really well. But what I like about the newer 2022 version is kind of like the chainmail on the shoulders. I think that looks really cool. Like the scale chainmail, I think that's a nice little touch. I also like the color scheme a lot. Pulling up the away version, 2022 on the left, 2021 on the right. I think the gray color works really well. They still have the Legion Air helmet logo in the background of the 2021 jersey. If you find a high definition photo, you can see it. It's really cool. Again, this is where white really does work. I like the color scheme. Again, I love the scales or the chainmail on it. I think it again, this is one of the best jerseys in the league as well. It's really nice. I think almost the same from 2021-2022, except maybe I kind of like 2022 a little bit better because I really do think it's cool with the scale chainmail on the shoulder pads. But I really like the San Diego Legion's jerseys. Moving on, this is pulling up the Seattle Seawolves 2022 kit. This is where I feel the logo of a sponsor, this Wofford Bank, I don't even know what it's supposed to be. It's kind of like a star, but kind of like a wobbly star. I just feel this doesn't work as a jersey logo, which is disappointing because, I really liked their last year's kit, but I think I like last year's kit because of the color scheme, which they kind of moved away from. I'm going to pull up the home jerseys, 2022 on the left, 2021 on the right. Now, this one, the 2021 home kit, yeah, not a huge fan of. The lines, very simple, but doesn't really work too much for me. Honestly, I don't like either one, but it's the away version. The green just works for me for whatever reason. I think it's just the neon colors that really gravitates towards me. And I always felt that was one of the best 2021 jerseys in MLR. Regardless of the logo, it kind of fades away because of the cool color scheme. But now you look at 2022, and this is where I feel white doesn't work. It just doesn't. Again, it just doesn't work for me. I feel this is a real downgrade for the kits, and I'm not a big fan of the Seattle Seawolves kits for this year. Moving on now to Utah, and this is the 2022 kits. Again, sadly, another instance where I feel like the logo just doesn't work for their sponsor, Intermountain Healthcare. I get what it is. It's supposed to kind of look like a mountain. But I just I just don't think it looks very good on a jersey, on a kit. Pulling up now the comparison between 2021-2022, and kind of just a slight difference. I still like the 2021 design because it doesn't have the Intermountain Healthcare logo. Instead it's kind of a simple black and red, which is always a great color scheme. But what I really like is their away jersey for 2021. It's just, this screams Utah because you have the mountains in the background, which I think is a really, really nice touch. And it just, it looks really cool. Again, red and black's a great color scheme. And then you see 2022, and again, more lines, which seems to be kind of the theme of 2022 with a lot of the clubs. And that Intermountain Healthcare, just not feeling it. Not feeling it at all. Again, I feel this was kind of a downgrade for Utah. I felt the 2021 away kit was really, really good. And the last team for the Western Conference, that was the last team of the Western Conference. Now we're going to move on to the Eastern Conference. And starting with that, we got arguably probably the number one team in the MLR right now, your Rugby ATL. And this is their 2022 kits. Again, I feel this is where a sponsorship logo looks really, really cool on jersey. Barbour, Orthopedics and Spine. Just that cool B shape. Real sleek. Fits perfectly on a jersey, I feel. Again, lines on the top. Running theme of 2022 for the kits. Bringing up the comparisons with last year's jerseys. Again, 2022 on the left, 2021 on the right. Pretty much kind of the same. I kind of feel it's a little bit of a downgrade because the 2021 one had kind of a cool, I don't know if it shows up on this picture, but the chainmail they kind of had covering the body and the logo. It's kind of there, but not as prominent in 2022, and then they just put the line on the top. They really do like their lines in this season of the kits. Flipping over to the way, it's just a change in color scheme. That's all that it is, from a dark grayish black to a white color. And again, white's not too bad on this one. I feel, again, if you add in more of that chainmail on the 2021 version, looks better for the white with 2022. But, I never felt the ATL jerseys were ever that bad to begin with, and they really didn't change too much for 2022, except for adding the line, which is kind of similar to what the Giltinis did. So, not hating on the ATL jerseys, because I felt they're pretty good to begin with. Moving on from ATL, we're going with Old Glory DC. Now, Old Glory DC, kind of did something which I felt most teams probably should have done. Just didn't change it. Went with the same design. They didn't have any change from 2022. I like their design. Again, another one where the logo looks pretty cool on a jersey. Cuisine Solutions. Really sleek CS design for Cuisine Solutions. I like the American flag kind of going across to represent DC. And yeah, I think it's a really cool, really, really cool jersey. Home with the blue, away with the white, both works, patriotic colors, it's a really cool jersey, which also does with something I think most jerseys should be doing, is to kind of show you and represent what their city and home is all about. So if you ever saw a jersey, did not know what city or state it's from, you could have a good guess about it. Like, obviously, this has to probably do with something with America, and D.C., the capital of America, the United States, would be an obvious choice. Going back to the Utah jersey, what I really like was the mountains. I mean, Utah mountains, it's a very good design. I really like this jersey. Strong contender. They had no reason to change anything, so I'm cool with them doing that. Another cool design. Well, actually, correction. I thought... they have a cool design. We have upcoming the New England Free Jacks. Boom. 2022. I really like this design. Some people were kind of giving it a little bit of crap online from what I saw, but I really like this. I'm going to pull up the comparison with 2021. And here we go. Boom, right there. Home and away. This is where, again, logo, the alloy, just fits perfectly. I actually feel it's a better look than the 2021 version, even though the lines are now bigger, I think it just fits. And again, you know, New England, you know, you think about Americana with New England, and the red, white, blue, it just really works. It really, really works with that. And then you flip it, the color scheme just slightly changed for the away. And again, I think it works. I really feel the 2022 version is better than the 2021 version. 2021 version is not bad, it's just kind of plain, but I really like the 2022 version. It's a really, really cool, really cool look. Moving on now, we are going to New Orleans, NOLA Gold. They obviously kind of play off of the gold and white. I like the fact that they're playing around with the crisscross pattern, which is very Harlequin-ish, kind of fits in the Mardi Gras theme. So again, when you think of Mardi Gras, obviously you think of New Orleans, the Big Easy. You know, it represents them. Pulling up the comparison, you know, not a big difference, at least with the home jerseys. Boom. Just, you know, the Louisiana on the front. I think it works. They didn't really do much of a change. But it's the away version that I really like, because now you add in the black. And for whatever reason, the black and the gold really pops. A little bit better than the kind of, like almost like a wet drip on the front. Which is a cool design, but I really like how the black and the gold kind of pop off really well on that jersey. Strong contender for 2022. We got now Rooney, 2022 version. Rooney is one of those teams that have a third jersey that's only for members. They do a really cool thing with their members' jerseys, is where they write the names of some of their first fans that bought tickets, and that's etched into the shirt or the kit, which I think is a really nice touch. That's very, very cool. I don't have a picture of it here, but just again, some really interesting and cool things that some clubs have done. But this is the 2022 jerseys for New York, and let's pull up the comparisons. You know, the home kit, I'm kind of on the fence of this one. I don't know how I really feel about the 2022 version. I kind of like the color scheme. I kind of like the design. Don't like the sponsorship again. Vane Freight, you know, it's a little bit too big. It just doesn't fit for me. I'm on the fence if I like the Statue of Liberty kind of in the corner, kind of making a little appearance there. Again, it does fit the motif, New York. What do you think of? Statue of Liberty, of course. So, you know, it kind of fits, but I'm kind of on the fence whether or not I like it or if I think it's any better than the 2021 version. Moving to the away version, a different color scheme, white. It was predominant for the 2022 version. I really like the orange one from 2021. I think it's a pretty good color scheme. And again, I'm just kind of on the fence if I like the Statue of Liberty being there or not. So, I don't know. We got one more. Last one is the Toronto Arrows with their new jersey. Again, not a fan of that logo. Cool bet sponsorship, you know, again, kind of fits. I mean, if you think of cold and Toronto, which it is cold, polar bear. So, but man, I am not feeling that big polar bear on the jersey. Pulling up the comparison with 2021, you know, the 2021 one is very simple. Honda obviously was a sponsor, which, yeah, no, it's not against that one. I like the Honda better than the cool bet with the bear, and going on to now the away, and just now more stripes, you know, kind of an arrow shape on the away 2022 version, but yeah, not a fan of that one, Not really a fan of that one. So yeah. So those are the kits for all 13 teams. I don't know what I'm gonna do with the betting, but the poll and the picking if we're doing a poll. But if there's interest in it, I'll definitely try something. I have an Instagram account. If you don't know, it's under Rugby411 Official. I'll put a link in it in the description of this video. If we do any voting, maybe I'll have that in the comment section. And I'll put maybe some polls up on the Instagram, because you can do like a little poll section on the story part. So follow me on the Instagram if you want to take part in that poll and the voting. You can put your votes down in the descriptions. If there seems to be a lot of votes, we'll kind of make it official. What I think I'm going to do first is we'll go home versus away for each individual team, which gives you a lot of chances to vote. Also, it then you kind of figure out which jersey we're kind of putting against everybody else. Once we pick which jersey is representing the teams, I'll put maybe a new video up for YouTube and the Instagram to kind of then set the field. What we'll probably do is we'll kind of, maybe we'll run it like they do with the MLR playoffs. We'll get the top three teams in each division, and then maybe we'll do a free-for-all with all six, and we'll pick the top two from there, and then that will be the finals, and then we'll go from there. So, you know, again, I think this is just a little fun video. I was never into jerseys or caring about what jerseys look like until I got into rugby, and I think it's kind of just a little fun thing to do, to kind of see and vote on these jerseys. So let me know what you think. Let me know what your favorites are. Let me know if you thought my taste is completely off, and let me know what you think of stripes, which apparently is the theme of 2022 for the jerseys. And hopefully we'll get this poll going if there's enough interest. But anyway, thank you very much for watching my video, and I'll see you on the pitch.